Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Our World. In this episode, we are going to talk about shotgun Remington 870. Yes, accidents happen. If you guys are not paying attention or you don't know about your X and proofs, accident happens like that. And I was just doing it for the demonstration purpose, but it could have been very dangerous and kill someone. So guys, before getting into firearms, I would like to discuss about X and proofs. To handle firearms safely and be a responsible shooter, you should know about X and PROVE. X and PROVE is an acronym. It stands for: assume every firearm you are holding is loaded, control the muzzle direction, finger off the trigger guard all the time, see if the firearm is unloaded. Then for PROVE, point the muzzle in the safest available direction, remove the cartridges from remove the shells or from your gun, observe the feeding tube. This is called the feeding tube, where you put your cartridges. So observe the feeding tube, verify the feeding path, nothing in here, and then examine the bore from the top. Yes, it's safe to examine the bore once you have followed all the steps in X and PROVE. So a little bit about the shotguns. So basically there are three or four different types of actions in the shotgun. One is break action. As you guys have seen, like those break action shotguns, they have single barrel or double barrel. Then there are pump action. This is a pump action Remington 870. Then we have semi-automatics and automatic. Then we let's talk about the cartridges we use, or the shells we use for shotgun. So this is a 12 gauge shotgun. So whenever you are putting a cartridge in your gun, you should know about your weapon, that what your weapon is, what its specifications are. So as you can see, this is Remington 870. I don't know if my camera will catch the name on it. So this is Remington 870 Super Magnum. So basically what Super Magnum means, that this specific gun can take 3.5 inch shells too. And if it's not Magnum, so it will take only 3 inch shells. Now let's talk about the shells. Whenever you are about to insert shell into your gun, make sure about the size of the shell. So on the back of the shell, it's 12. So that means it's a 12 gauge cartridge. On the side, it's 3 inch, one of an 1/8 inch BB cartridges. So basically this shell is used for waterfowl hunting. Like if you are hunting for geese, ducks, you use these because they are like they travel fast. Then we have these cartridges. They are normal bird shots, again 12 gauge. Then we have these small cartridge. They are used for small bird hunting, like grouse and stuff. And my favorite slug. This is an ounce slug, and it's 12 gauge too. So now, without any further ado, let's go to shooting. But before getting into shooting, as I mentioned in my earlier video, that you, as a for being a responsible shooter or hunter, make sure about your surrounding, that your surrounding is clear. So for that, I'm using my outbound binoculars. And for range, again, Bushnell rangefinder. So yes guys, let's go shoot these cartridges. I will show you guys the impact that and the spread of each cartridge. And yeah, it will be fun. Oh, before ending this video, I know it's like for advanced, like it's not for beginners, but these are the chokes. So right now I have improved cylinder in my gun. This is another choke. So it's for shooting like decoys and stuff. And this is my turkey choke. So just to give you guys an idea about chokes too. So these are the chokes. They go on the top of your barrel, and they control the spread of the pellets in your shell. First shot I am taking is from this Magnum shell. It's 3.5 inch, and the pellets are steel. So let's see the impact of it. guys, so this is a close-up from this cartridge. You can, as you can see, the impact of it. So that's pretty close. I am shooting from approximately like 15 yards. So this is a spread out from 15 yards from these Kench cartridges, Magnum. So the second shot we are taking from this bird shell. So let's see the spread of it. Alright guys, let's go and check out the impact. So as you guys can see from the bird shot, the pellets are very small as compared to the steel pellets, and the spread is little bit wide than the steel pellets. So yeah, I hope you guys can see the difference between the size of the pellets and the spread. So for my third shot, I'm using these Grouse cartridges, and it's 7.5 12 gauge, and the gun is again Remington 870. So let's go guys, check it out. The impact from Grouse shot. So guys, as you can see, the pellet size from this shell is more smaller in diameter, and the spread is more. As you can see, this is from it, this all spread is from this cartridge. It's an ounce slug from my Remington 870. So let's see how it goes. So yeah, that's all we are going to shoot today. So as you can see, that this is the entry of the slug, and this is the exit of the slug. Thanks for coming with me today, and I hope you enjoyed this video. In the future videos, I will cover up firearm safety in more detail. So just for a review, these are the shots we took today. This is from the steel pellets, this is the bird shot, and this is the grouse shot, and finally my favorite, this is the slug. If you like this video, please share it with your friends. Our world, respect, explore and enjoy together, and shoot that like button guys.